Did you know that science is a lot like music? In both fields, pre-existing knowledge is used as inspiration, like a foundation to create something new. This is also the case for Andrew Fire, Craig Mello, and their team in their journey to uncover double-stranded RNA-dependent RNA interference. They used scientific milestones such as previous studies on interferon defense against RNA viruses, as well as later establishments of Crick's central dogma of biology and double-stranded RNA as inspiration for their 1998 paper that won the 2006 Nobel Prize. What truly inspired them was the question of just how double-stranded RNA and this interferon mechanism fits into the central dogma. First tested in the mid-1980s, the hypothesis was that viral interference was triggered by foreign antisense RNA. Theoretically, antisense RNA could be transcribed from transgenic DNA to then bind to the sense proportion of mRNA, preventing translation. Basically, the antisense RNA would then produce a similar effect to a hand over a speaker interfering with the music, or in this case, gene expression. The initial experiment formed the foundation for the Fire article, much like a baseline forms the backbone of a song. The experiment was conducted on C. elegans, a transparent round worm which was injected with DNA fragments containing the UNC22 gene. It was already known that reduced expression of this gene resulted in twitching behavior, so that was used as an indication of interference. The effect of both sense and antisense RNA were tested. However, unexpectedly, both injections resulted in twitching. Just like when a composer stumbles upon the perfect melody but it doesn't quite fit the baseline, Fire and his team decided to try and alter their hypothesis, their baseline, to explain these results. In 1995, a hint towards the issue emerged alongside the discovery that RNA could be directly injected into C. elegans, eliminating the need for transgenic DNA. Fire realized a potential issue from the use of RNA polymerase in preparing transgenic RNA. From his previous experiences, he knew that using such mechanisms could result in the single-stranded RNA being contaminated with double-stranded RNA. Building off this, the prepared RNA was purified using gel electrophoresis. Not only was this able to produce purified RNA for testing, it was also able to indicate the presence of double-stranded RNA, confirming Fire's suspicions. Since the electrophoresis showed that the previously injected material was predominantly double-stranded RNA, that was also tested. The comparison between these results made it clear that RNA interference was actually triggered by double-stranded RNA instead of single-stranded RNA. While the purified single-stranded RNA required a high dosage to produce marginal interference activities, the hybridized double-stranded RNA showed highly efficient interference that was at least 2 times as efficient, only requiring a very low dose to work. In a sense, these results unveiled the main countermelody of Fire's masterpiece, installing double-stranded RNA as a key part in RNA interference. But this was only the beginning. Fire's team also tested double-stranded RNA derived from non-coding regions that showed no effect, suggesting that interference occurred at a post-transcriptional level. This was affirmed by testing an injection of RNA derived from the MEX3 gene that had mRNA that could be stained and observed. Individuals injected with purified antisense RNA were still producing mRNA, while double-stranded RNA injected individuals were not, confirming that RNA interference functioned by causing mRNA degradation. Other characteristics of RNA interference were also tested, but the exact mechanisms unfortunately could not be concluded by Fire and his team. However, even without all the answers, this paper was still crucial in paving the way for future discoveries, as it formed a solid foundation for a new field of research. Uncovering the existence of RNA interference in other organisms soon broadened this field of research, leading to discoveries that furthered our understanding of RNA, such as the discovery of key components of mechanisms of RNA interference, and similar mechanisms for microRNA. This established the role of RNA as a regulatory signal, extending beyond the central dogma to drive forward major advancements in the field of epigenetics.